shit. You gotta be right.
Those having an earache. Apparently, the severity of the earache, you know what? It happens at night time. You know the reason why? Because at night time, you are doing nothing. You are focused on certain things and certain feelings you're having. Same thing with the Christian life. The more you get focused on something, and maybe at one point you realize and you experience this thing. The more you're getting focused on your discipleship thing, on your Christian life, the more that you realize that there's a lot of balances, there's a lot of variation, there's a lot of distractions in your one's life. Amen? Something that you never realized before when you were not so focused that at all. Amen? So if there's a point that you got distracted, always remember this. Maybe that's the time where you're getting so focused at what you are doing. Amen? And I'm telling you this. When you started to become so serious with your spiritual journey, with your Christian walk, with your discipleship walk with God, and I'm telling you this. The enemy is so very serious about you, distract you in one way or another. Amen? And one of the delegates in the conference last 2 weeks ago, at one point he even called, you know, Benny, if God is giving you something to accomplish, if God is going to give you a higher task, I'm telling you this, the enemy will also give you at the same ground of the devil. But by the way, what do you call devil? It's a devilized now. Demonized now. I don't think so. If God is setting you and preparing you to do something great for His glory, the enemy will also give something almost of your same realm, the way God has told you, to distract you. And sometimes the distraction, and this is the dangerous thing about distraction. The dangerous thing about distraction is you are getting distracted sometimes and most of the time without noticing them. Amen? And sometimes you look at the distractions as a legitimate things, but the truth is they are the legitimate deceptions of the enemy. Are you with me? Amen? And then please, enemy has so many eyes on you. You know what you're doing, you know what you are, you know what areas of your life you are having a triumph. And even the enemy knows at what areas of your life that you're struggling with. And most of the time, in the areas where you're having a struggle, that the enemy can capitalize and do his job. Amen? But those are distractions. But on the other side, distraction is also God's way of setting you apart for something else. I'm telling you this, distractions is not always a bad thing before God. And even the worst thing before God, you can turn it into some kind of a blessing in your life. Amen? But you need to be focused. Amen? Maybe you're having a job, you're so focused on achieving certain things, but at one point something happened and it stopped you for a while. Amen? You know, distraction is like a bump on the road. Amen? Who's driving here? You know, the bumps on the road, the purpose of the bump is not to stop you from driving. What's the purpose of that? To slow you down. Amen? There are some moments you have to slow down, but there are moments that you really have to keep at a certain speed. Same thing with your walk with God. At one point, the way whether it is the enemy or whether it is God who distracted you, who stopped you, who slowed you down, or what you're doing for God, you know what? You have to be thankful. You have to be thankful. Amen? The most important thing, for as long as you won't stop following Him. Amen? Even church leaders, even pastors, even the great men of God, at one point, they slow down. Amen? Look at the person right beside you. Mukha pang slow down. Does it look slow down in one way? Amen. Maybe at one point you're so eager serving God during the first time you came to know God. Amen, ba? Can you relate? The first time you came to know God, you would like to spend most of the time in the church. Amen. You're attending the worship service, the midweek service, you attend the summer camp, the youth camp, you attend the discipleship class, and then at one point, because of the distraction, you slow down. Amen? I'm telling you this, that's normal, because that is one of the roads that most Christians need to go through. Kung hindi mo ba nadadaanan yan, if you haven't been in that road before, expect one of these days. I'm not saying that we have to, but that's reality of life. Amen ba? Sino pong hindi naka-experience ito? Who among people who didn't experience distraction? All of us. Amen? Another one, I'm just gonna try to pass by through this thing. And another road that we are talking about is the road of what? The road of discouragement. The road of disappointment. Amen? Amen? You know, there's a lot of people in this place, especially those married people. During the time of courtship, when you feel so full of encouragement, you're full of love. Every time you look out, there's a heart shape everywhere. Everything is colored. And sometimes you think that if you're going to marry that person, you're going to be the luckiest, quote unquote, the luckiest person to ever live. Smile at daytime, nighttime, ringtime. Because you're full. And then only to realize that one boy said, well, Lord, I'm going to marry you. I think I'm the luckiest person alive. And then when you got married, sabi ni William. And then when you got married, there's a lot of disappointment. Amen? When you realize some of the hidden characters of the person that you married. So, oh wow, I didn't realize you. Amen. During the time when you're still having a date, you know, every time you're having a dinner, you're having a meal, you know, the way she eats or he eats is so very mean and proper. Amen. The way they speak, the way they relate to you. And then after you got married, the monster came out. Amen? Amen? Young people, I'm telling you this, you know, it's a bit of a... I'm telling you this, during the time of courtship and the relationship, let your boyfriend and girlfriend knows all about you. Even the worst side of you. Amen? Because at one point, it's really hard to... Do you know what makes disappointment so hard to bear and so hard to accept? Because most of the time, the disappointment is totally opposite of what we're expecting from a person. It is disappointment made even worse to accept when you realize that it's totally opposite of what you're expecting from a certain situation. Mm-hmm. Amen? And sometimes, I'm telling you this, and sometimes God gives you exactly opposite of what you've been praying for. Amen? Not to disappoint you, but to build some kind of a character that you haven't developed in your life before. Amen? I still remember, during the college time, because, you know, I'm not really in university course before. And when I was still in university, every time we were having, what do you call that, the sports intramurals, you know, our department, the College of Arts and Sciences, are having a big fight really with the nursing department, because the nursing department in the Philippines, they're so, for me, during the time, they're so arrogant, you know, they're so. And I said, And then we mock a lot of nursing students, oh, yeah, you are all rich people, you're all nice people, you're intelligent people, but not what you're doing in the hospital. In Tagalog, itagapunas lang naman kayo ng ano. You know, God made a joke and said, I'm going to meet your nurse. Dear Lord! Amen? Sometimes God's going to disappoint you so that God's going to put you in God's proper appointment in your life. Your disappointment is God's appointment. Sabi mo nga, your God's disappointment, your appointment, you know, becoming a priest. Your disappointment is God's appointment. Amen? Who can relate? Something you don't like, and then you can end up doing the thing. And sometimes the person you don't like is the person you marry. Amen? You're having a peace fight, you're having, you know, you don't agree on certain things, and Brother Manny says, I don't know why. Amen? Amen? And I said, you know, never in my wildest imagination that I'm going to marry this person. Because for me, this is not the ideal one. But you know what? Your ideal is not God's ideal for you. Because God knows best. It's not your mother who knows best. It's God who knows best. And just like what I said, disappointment is God's appointment in your life. He's disappointing you because he's got something better ahead of you. Amen? But that's not the topic for today. The topic I have for today is God's death tour. We're not in death tour. The tour, meaning to say, is having a different road from what you have planned, or going into something else, taking a different road from what has been previously planned. You know what? Christian life has many detours in your life. Amen? There's a lot of change planet, change road as you travel in this journey that we call life. Amen? What is the tour, and why God is allowing for us to go in this detour kind of thing? Detour is about the change in the plan or taking another road as God leads in you. What is your first reaction if you were in a hurry and then you have the exact travel time from here, let's say from here to Bournemouth, the cell block starts at 4:30, okay? And then we only have around 10 minutes leeway to get there. So we left Southampton 3:30, and then we're going to get to Bournemouth by around 4:20. And then along the way, you have seen the tour. And you know when you take that the tour thing, the instruction, it will give you another 30 minutes additional travel time. What is your normal reaction in a normal life? Oh no! Amen? Some people say, what the? Hey,